Hello, everyone. I'm Mike Lacona, professor of New Testament Studies at Houston Christian University. And we've got a fantastic Master of Arts in Christian Apologetics program. And I have two former students that I'm going to be interviewing tonight. And they're going to be telling you about their experience in the program and what they're doing now, how they got involved in it, what they want to do with the program. And so it's a real pleasure to have them on. My first guest is Jan Shultis, and she graduated from the program about 2 years ago. She's got a really cool background, which we'll talk about in a moment. She's presently, after finishing, she started a PhD at the University of Durham over in the UK. And then also joining us this evening is Samuel Hank, and he just completed his first year of medical school, and it was like the first year of medical school. It wasn't enough for him. He just had too much spare time on his hands, and he said, "What am I going to do with all this spare time and while I'm doing med school?" And so he decided to do the MA in Christian Apologetics at HCU. So Jan and Samuel, welcome. Thanks for joining me this evening.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for having us.
Awesome. Let me make my head a little smaller here. Okay. So let me ask you guys, tell us a little about yourself. Jan, why don't we start with you? Why don't you tell us, what's your background? I know you've done some military stuff and some really cool stuff from your past. What are you doing?
Thank you. Well, right now I'm talking to you all, which is the best use of time. So thank you for that. I am retired from the military. I entered into the military from the Naval Academy and had the privilege of serving throughout this great country of ours and a little bit of time overseas. After I retired, as is typical for military officers, I've had the opportunity to work in several different fields and consulting and writing and so on and so forth. So it was a curvy road that led to HCU, that's for sure. But an awesome one. I'm currently in clinical research and biotechnology with a focus on cell therapy.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Years ago, I was talking to a guy who did his undergraduate work at the Naval Academy, and then he did a master's degree at Harvard. And I said, compare your experience at the two. Which one did you get better education? And he said, the Naval Academy, hands down. He said the people to get into Harvard, you got to be smart. But he said, I didn't find the teaching there, especially, anything special about it. But he said the Naval Academy just gave me an amazing education experience. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. I know you got to be smart to get into there, too. Samuel, tell us about yourself. You're in the MD program in med school. Where are you attending?
sorry. So I'm at, geez, I'm at East Tennessee State University, which is one of Tennessee's state schools that focuses a lot on rural medical practice. Originally, I'm from Minnesota, actually, but I came to Tennessee to go to Vanderbilt for undergraduate, stuck around for a few years doing medical research, and then spent a gap year where I did most of my program with HCU and then started medical school.
Awesome. Now, how much longer do you have at HCU?
I have my thesis and one other course, which I think is one of the starter courses technically. So I just missed that one, but.
Wow. Okay, cool. Well, Jan, how did you become interested in Christian apologetics? When did you start? How did you get interested in it?
I wish I had a more intellectually compelling story, but here's the honest to goodness truth. I was raised in the church and absolutely considered myself a Christian, but it was later in life that I started to develop a true understanding of Christianity and of a tripartite God, right? A God in three parts. And then I had never heard the word apologetics. I saw an ad for HCU on digital media, and it was advertising the program. I could not stop thinking about it. And that was right when COVID hit. And the opportunity, you know, availed itself to go there. So I did. And it was the most unexpected, most wonderful adventure. It changed everything. But that is not a fancy story. But that's how I ended up there.
Well, that's pretty cool. How about you, Samuel?
Well, I think I've always sort of been interested in apologetics, I guess, since high school. I spent a lot of time struggling with my faith, and I had kind of a hobby of watching online debate, well, not online debates, but debates posted online, Christians versus atheists. So I've always kind of been interested in the argument and the discussion from that end. And then with COVID, I was in kind of a bad place in my life, really wanted to reevaluate my faith and what I was doing. And, you know, am I actually living in line with what I think I believe? What do I actually believe? And kind of just as part of that process, I stumbled upon the program at HCU, and it's been great.
Now both of you are, I had you both for two classes, two courses. Jan, did you do yours entirely online?
It was entirely online, even though I am local to Houston. And that is something that I really want to encourage anyone who happens to see this to really give online learning a chance. It was a phenomenal experience. But as someone who has worked full time, I'm an older student, right? Won't say how much older, but older. And so as someone who is already well progressed in their career, I'm also a single parent to a 10-year-old daughter. So logistically, I would not have been able to pursue this course of study were it not for the phenomenal quality of HCU's online program. So I cannot say enough good things about it. It was wonderful.
That's pretty cool. How about you, Samuel? Are you entirely online, or have you taken some on campus?
No, so I've been entirely online, and I mean, that's been great.
In, well, I guess you're in Tennessee, right? So, yeah.
Well, I'm in Tennessee now, but I started in Nashville. I continued in Portland, and then I finished in East Tennessee. So it's been really great for the flexibility of constantly moving.
Yeah, so tell us about your experiences. Like Samuel, what have you found have been the disadvantages of studying online, learning online, taking these online?
Well, I mean, I think I don't want to say there's less room for engagement, but most courses are structured in sort of a seminar encouraged style. And there's certainly within that, there's discussion forums online, and there's people who will participate more and participate less in that to a certain extent. And so if you were in person, there's definitely the benefit of when you ask someone a question, they're not just going to stare blankly and never respond. But online, that can happen in some discussion forums. So that's certainly a downside, but you learn to overcome it. You know, there are people who participate more, and you engage with them, and, you know, you put out interesting things in the forums, and you get plenty of responses, and the professors are always great about giving you their thoughts and engaging with you.
Jan, did you find any disadvantages to learning online?
You know, I honestly didn't. Not a single one comes to mind. The only thing that it brings up that I wouldn't call a disadvantage is, you know, you meet these people who you want to spend time with because they're intelligent and they have similar interests. And you can't spend enough time with them. You love them. You want to get to know them more, but that would be true in person as well. I can't think of a single disadvantage, and I can't reiterate strongly enough, this course of study would not have been possible for me without the online program. So
I think we lost Samuel.
Did we lose Samuel?
Yeah, he'll come back to us, I would guess. So at least you don't have to get up and do exercising every morning when you're in the MA in Christian Apologetics, right?
Oh,
a little different
no.
than
oh,
the Naval Academy.
It was so, well, and Mike, I was so anti-grad. Like, the true story is so dippy. I mean, beyond the, well, I'd never heard the word till I went to go get my master's, which is true. But it's Yeah, the Naval Academy is wonderful, but it grows people, whole people, you know, and that's a different endeavor. It's just a different style of education. This was such a gift. By the way, varsity level bookcase situation.
The what?
You have a varsity level bookcase situation, and you're even packing and moving. I love seeing all your books arranged.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I started packing those out, you know, like I said, right before we went on. We're getting ready to move. And so, yeah, I try to leave some books on the shelf until after this. But hey, so Jan, you're doing your PhD at Durham, and you're still in Houston. So you're doing your doctorate at a great university online. What's that like? How does
Essentially,
that differ from what your program at HCU?
what's well, it's amazing. Both experiences were amazing, and you know, ending up at Durham was fortuitous in all the ways, right? So I ended up there because I found my supervisor first. So it's a PhD by research, which requires a pretty fully formed project, you know, synopsis, and then you have to find somebody who will supervise it. And one of the leading experts in the world, on the topic of moral injury in general, including combat-related moral injury, what I study, is actually an American who fought in Iraq and Afghanistan, but is currently a chair at Durham University. So, what happened? I can't speak to the state of their online programs or their distance programs before COVID, but I know that certainly, you know, post-COVID, when I began there last year, they have a very robust and well-articulated mechanisms for allowing people to complete research, really from anywhere in the world. And so, there is an expectation that you go to, you know, to England at certain points, later in the program, but it's one of those things. It would not be possible as someone, you know, currently established in a dynamic career with a child, to pursue this without the online component. It's wonderful.
Yeah. You know, I did my doctorate entirely online at the University of Pretoria. Would I have preferred to have been there in person on campus and learning? And mine was a research degree as well, as it is when you do it not in the United States. They just expect a little bit more out of your dissertation, of course, or a lot more out of it. But yeah, I would I have enjoyed being there more? Maybe. But you know, back then when I was doing it from 2003 through 2008, I talked on a regular basis with my doctoral supervisor via Skype. I don't know if there was Zoom back then, but I did via Skype. When you're doing a research program like that, there are no courses. It's just, you know, you're working with your supervisor. And so we do that. And I'd meet up with him once a year at the annual meeting of the Society of Biblical Literature. And then I would, you know, do my chapters and send them. So I don't feel like I lost anything. I mean, it's nice to talk to them face to face, but I mean, this is the first time we're talking face to face, or maybe Jan, I don't know, we might have done it once before. I forgot. While
We
you were a
have
student.
gathered to promo HCU, the great HCU. Yeah, but yes, it's certainly one of the first few. And you know, and to speak to the differences, I can't think of a difference that is not more fundamentally related to the difference between a master's program and a PhD program. I mean, the PhD pro the dissertation by distance is more isolated, which is, I would say, likely true. I mean, I felt so wrapped in community during the MAA program, but part of that's a function of having actual courses with requirements for posting and interacting, and you don't have that. I mean, you're alone on an island in the PhD. Yeah, I cannot say enough good things about it in both cases.
Samuel, how did you find how so far, how have you found your, I mean, just bracket me out so you don't have to talk about me, but how have you found your professors? You know, at HCU.
Yeah, well, I mean, with one exception, they've been great. But Overall, they've been really, really great. I mean, there's a good mixture of professors who will really challenge you and push back in really very engaging and very meaningful ways with the work that you'll present them with. And there are also professors who have been great at being very encouraging in getting you to explore your ideas more and just to improve on whatever the course topic is, whether that's gaining a better basis of knowledge in something very specific or a course in communication skills. They've just been phenomenal overall, and I think part of that lends itself or comes from the fact that many of the professors aren't in Houston themselves, and we have just a wide range of faculty that are have different, not day jobs, but day positions that they spend their time with.
Yeah. I know with some folks, not at HCU, but I've heard from some who learn online at other universities where they say their professors really don't engage much with the students during the course. They'll respond to emails, they'll talk a little bit on the discussion forms, but it's just they just he just the professor just kind of leave the students to themselves. Have either of you found that to be the case at HCU in the MAA program?
No, I mean not at all. Like I'm saying, I think if anything, I've been surprised with how thoroughly most professors engage with the work I submit, more so than I found in my undergraduate courses, honestly.
How about you, Jan?
I have had the most phenomenal experience. From a more objective standpoint, I think the roster of apologists at HCU is deep. That it's an extremely diverse faculty with a lot of different perspectives, a lot of different experiences, but what they have in common is they tend to be leaders in their field. And so I think if you hold up HCU and you look at the faculty and you compare it to the faculty of, similar programs at other universities, there is no comparison. HCU is far and above. And that is testament to the quality of the faculty. On a personal level, I was deeply moved by how much the faculty repeatedly demonstrated personal caring, not only for me, but for, every student of which I was aware in the classes. The faculty that I had the privilege of learning from, I think truly believe in the value of online learning and really gave themselves to it. I mean, they spent time in online instruction, they spent time in facilitation, they spent time in follow-up. And some of the most deeply influential interactions that I had with faculty came because my primary professor took a conversation that was going and said, "Hey, you need to talk to my colleague," right? And then introduced me to their colleague to continue the conversation in a more nuanced or technical or whatever way. It is very common to hear your professors say they're praying for you. And I will tell you now that I'm a couple years post-graduation, and as an older student, I have the privilege of calling many of them my friends. I still see them regularly. In some cases, I work with them. And I will tell you that is true. When they say they pray for you, they pray for their students, they do, right? I can think of no better testament of caring. So the reason that the MAA at HCU is transformative goes beyond the content of the courses themselves, and it is a testament to the people there.
That's pretty cool you say that. And what you said before about community, that is something I've noticed and other students have said too, that there is like a community of the students and it's just really cool. They like each other, they fellowship with each other. And what I like about it as a faculty member there, it's that way amongst the faculty that we don't all agree on the secondary and well maybe the tertiary issues, doctrinal issues, but we all agree on the primary, the essential doctrines of the Christian faith. And it's like, we disagree on some of the other stuff, but we all get along. And that is so unusual that's a sad testimony that it's unusual, but it is unusual in a lot of Christian universities where you have diversity of some opinions, but people, the faculty still get along and they're okay with it. So that's pretty neat. Really like that. So how have the two of you been able to use what you've learned so far? Sam,
well,
Samuel?
Yeah, I think the content has been phenomenal. But more than that, I think my writing skills have improved dramatically throughout the course, both in being able to efficiently and quickly write something that's a very good analysis of a piece of work, as well as, you know, just being able to read and digest in that way, but also really being able to write in-depth analyses through the papers. I think my writing has improved in a way that I can't say anything else really has since maybe, you know, third grade, but not in degree at least. And I think that really is a result of not just the kind of program it is, but the professors, like I say, who don't go easy on you, especially if you, you know, engage with them. They'll give you back what you give them and give you great feedback.
Cool. Jan?
Personally, it's changed everything. I mean, it's changed the way I think. It's changed the way I pray. It's changed the way I speak. It's changed what I read. It's changed everything. Professionally, not to sound cliche, but also it has changed. It's changed everything because it changed the way I think and it changed the way I write. It was the perfect platform for what I'm doing now, which is a call on my life, right? It's this level of research, both professionally and in my doctoral program, would not have been possible without the thought formation that occurred at HCU. HCU has also prepared me, you know, so if you're in my PhD is in will be in theology when it's finished. And so I think if you're involved in anything in these fields, apologetics, theology, anything related to Christianity, right, there will come a point where people try and sway you from that. People try and influence that, or it's just slowly eroded away as a consequence of living in our society and in this time, right? So what HCU did most foundationally is it made me stronger. Made me stronger in ways I didn't know I needed to be strengthened. It's been quite a ride.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I think you were in the program, Jan, around the same time Mike DeVito was, the guy that used to play in the NFL. Were you? Or did you come after him?
I was slightly after, but claim to knowing him. He did facilitate one of our guest lecture calls, I think. He was working the slides.
Oh, okay. So he's doing his PhD in philosophy over at, I think it's Birmingham. And he said the HCU program in apologetics just really prepared him because most of the people that he talks with in the program, the other students, and he's doing it online as well over there. He said, you know, most of them aren't Christians. A lot of them are atheists and agnostics. And he said, they're really sharp students, but the MAA at HCU really prepared him to be able to engage and to prevail in discussions like that, to be able to answer adequately and provide good responses to their challenges. So that's pretty cool. So, final question. What would you guys say to others who are considering studying the Master of Arts in Apologetics at HCU? Samuel?
Yeah, I think I would say just go. I think you can get them on the website. I would just go into the recommended program and look at the course lists, look at the course titles. And I think you can even see some of the reading lists and some of the like recommended before you read. And I mean, just get a sense of it and say, you know, are these topics that I really would love to dive into more, that I'd love to spend a lot of time engaging with people, talking about, analyzing, and getting to understand on a deeper level? And if the answer is yes, then I don't think there's really a better, more flexible, and I mean, more engaging program for that kind of work that, I mean, certainly not with that kind of flexibility that HCU offers.
Awesome. Yeah, thanks on that. Jan?
I would tell someone considering the MA program at HCU to do it. If you're drawn to it, you should do it, and you can do it. You can take the program at your own pace. That's the other thing. The faculty is wonderfully accommodating, and this goes up to senior leadership, of, you know, varied life circumstances. So especially if it's been a while since you've been in the classroom, for me, it had been nearly 20 years, and I always swore up and down I was never going to go to grad school because my career was so well established. Why did I need grad school, right? But especially if you're an older student, there is so much opportunity for joy without the pressure and stress that you may remember from previous educational experiences. If you go back to school as an adult, it should be because you want to. Mm-hmm. And if you're drawn to this program at HCU, go. Just go. Learn, dive in, and enjoy every single conversation. I promise you, you will.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for that. Gosh, I didn't get into my doctoral program and start studying until I was, let's see, it was 2003. So I was 41 years old when I started my PhD program, when I started it.
And how was it?
It was fantastic. And, you know, it's like, I couldn't have just picked up my family and moved, because I was looking at going to Birmingham over there and studying with Mark Goodacre in New Testament studies at Birmingham. He's now at Duke. And we were talking about it, but it's like, wow, I would have had to pick up my family and go over. And, you know, it was just to do it at the University of Pretoria where I did it, and to do it online pretty much. That just really worked for me. And I don't feel like I lost anything in the quality, and it just really helped me at that time in life, you know? So, yeah. And, you know, I'll say one other thing, and maybe you guys can agree or disagree with this or add to it. You know, one thing I really appreciate about HCU compared to some other universities that offer master's degree in Christian apologetics, most of the other universities will, I mean, and let's face it, you study Christian apologetics, it's usually at a conservative, an evangelical university or seminary. They usually are very, very ultra conservative and require students to embrace some kind of a statement of faith. I have no problems with that, but what I like about HCU is the faculty are diverse. So we all have to embrace a mere Christianity kind of doctrinal statement, just the essentials of the Christian faith. And other than the essentials, we disagree on a lot of the non-essentials. So, and students do not have to take any kind of doctrinal position. So I like to tease my friends at these other schools, other programs, and say, you know, at such and such a place, you know, you do a great job of teaching your students what to think, but at HCU, we teach our students how to think. And so that's kind of difference that we find. Would you guys say that you find some good diversity in the non-essentials? Jan? Because I see that Samuel is frozen here.
Samuel looks frozen. I was like, wait a second. Yes, I was. I was so unexpectedly impressed by the diversity of the student body and of the faculty. You know, I was nervous to go back to school as a parent and as a military veteran and as an older student. And it worked out great because I was in great company. You know, there were people older, there were people younger, there were people far more senior in their careers, there were a lot of other parents, and people from all over the world. And with that comes a diversity of thought, which to me is the most important marker in diversity. To echo what you said is, you know, diversity of experience breeds diversity of thought. And that's what we value in the military, because no person can be a silo and come up with the best solution. And that's true in, that's scripturally true as well. But apologetics is by default relational, right? You're not sitting there arguing with yourself most of the time. You're sitting there engaging in interactions with other people. And so it was such good preparation. And it was so, it taught me to speak in different ways. It was wonderful.
No, that's cool. Well, thanks, Jan, for your chiming in on that. And, you know, you were just a fantastic student, brilliant, and just a wonderful, wonderful personality. And it was just such a joy having you in the course. Samuel, I always thought it was so cool that here you were in med school and also doing your MA in Christian apologetics. I mean, that's really impressive, brother.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, that stands out. I've not heard, that's remarkable. Remarkable. Good for you. Are you enjoying it? Do you like it?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I think they enrich each other. It's, so I guess I'll add, you know, even if you have a busy life, it's so great to be able to, even though both of my things are different schools, to really step outside what I'm doing in medicine to, you know, focus on, I mean, in Dr. Ward's course, you read The Lord of the Rings and like do a deep dive on that. So it's really great to step outside, or just this past semester, you know, be with Dr. Lacona going through historicity of the resurrection, like just a variance in the day made it feel like not work at all.
I appreciate that. Hey, I'm curious, you both, Jan, you wanted to say something?
I was just going to say, and this is probably too evangelical to be useful for the interview, but it has been amazing how God uses the knowledge and skills gained through the MAA in some of the most unexpected places. So now I have the privilege of spending my days in a clinical research organization, and we work in degenerative diseases and illnesses without cures, which means that a lot of the people that I have the privilege of meeting, they're very sick. Sometimes they're older. They're definitely thinking about death, and they're thinking about, you know, debilitation and things like this. And so the conversations that it gives rise to are really quite staggering, and they're unprecedented. Even though I came to HCU having run a nonprofit mental health organization that I founded for veterans and families for 10 years prior. So I thought I had a pretty well-developed skill set in this area. But what I didn't have was an ability to navigate conversations with people whose beliefs were wildly different from mine. And that's one thing that HCU, I mean, that's what apologetics is, right? That's one thing that HCU gave me. And when I say, I mean, Mike, I use the MAA experience every single day, whether it's with my daughter or another family member or somebody who comes through the doors of the clinic, every single day.
That's awesome. Well, Jan, Samuel, thanks so much for chiming in and talking about your experience at HCU, and certainly wish you the Lord's best in everything you're doing. God bless you both.
Thank you.
Thank you. You as well.
God bless you. Thank you, Mike.